See, this the Cali Kickback.
damn, this is got my nigga off on interrogation mode. See what I mean? He started talking for dark. Yeah, this nigga, he was a buster.
We gotta properly bring him into the shit because, you know what I'm saying, this is an L.A. legend, goddammit me. You know, so give a big round of applause for my boy WattsHomieQuan real quick.
Yeah.
I'm talking about.
Shout out to WattsHomieQuan.
You know what I'm saying? Appreciate you pulling up on us, goddamn me. Yeah,
with the new bus down, we not going
to. Yeah, Quan got his door to chew on. Quan bus down, nigga.
Fuck Brain in this motherfucker right now.
Hey, man, appreciate it, man. I nigga just trying to do a little bit.
Yeah, man, y'all say y'all the two reasons I really know about this L.A. shit, man. You, Teddy Ray, man, y'all done tapped me in, man. Now, I'm part of this L.A. movie, man. I'm a cousin out here. I'll be sliding through all the hood. Now they on flossing the hell of shit, nigga.
Man, they did pull up questions like, "What y'all doing out here?" Like, my uncle's staying around the corner. And they was one of the fewest niggas in this game that done pulled up slid on my auntie crib.
Yeah, hey man. Like, yeah, it was with my nigga Boomer. You know, yeah, nigga, that little DJ Boomer.
Yeah. Boomer, my nigga, shout out to Boomer, baby.
Yeah, that's a funny ass nigga.
Yeah, these some real LA niggas. They got mutual niggas that they the same niggas, but I didn't even know they was locked in with the same nigga. I'm like,
yeah.
You feel me?
That's how small LA is, nigga. It's a big ass city, dog.
Nope,
nigga,
it's
somebody know you.
Exactly. It's a bitch shit if you want to.
Somebody
just acting like you just a regular nigga. Somebody know you, bro, went outside and made a phone call, nigga.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I see why the Hollywood niggas be so scared to go on the other side of Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. Because it's totally different. It's just a totally different mentality, you know what I'm saying? Atmosphere, everything. It just feels so real. I just be like, when I go on the other side, I be like, all right, I'm just in my little Oakland head. I'll be like, all right, this the town. I got to move how it is. You know what I'm saying? Got to adapt.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, you got a long story. Like, your journey is so different, but so similar to mine. It's crazy. Do you remember when the first time we linked type shit? Because, man, it's been like 6 years now.
Yeah, look, nigga, the story is, this nigga Lou, he had DM'd me, and he'll like, I'm coming out there, I'm gonna fuck with you. I didn't think the nigga was gonna come. A lot of niggas say that shit, but right. Lou drove all the way from, you know, from the town, nigga, to the house in a red car. I forgot.
That was a rental.
Yeah. Oh, and it had, and I ain't gonna lie, had a bad little light skin one in the front seat.
For real?
You had a car with you.
You
had a car
with you. You tried to play somebody. You forgot. That was me. Oh, look.
Hey, that nigga Luke, his flex is different, nigga. That nigga said, oh, that was me? Damn, I forgot about that one.
But that's how you know your flex is real, because you gotta really live life like. Nigga, that was what I was doing back then. I don't know what was happening. I'm just
blessed. Oh, God, nigga.
And that show you that having a good woman on your side matters. That's a good first impression.
Man.
Because he remembered that. Yeah. And I did,
bro.
Good job, Lewis.
Yeah. it was like 2015, my nigga. You pulled up on me. He said that shit. And then I think like a year later, we eventually, when the times was right, nigga, we linked up. Because Lou was doing this thing. I was doing my shit on and off, but...
Now, you was doing your thing. That's why I had to reach out to you. Because, like, in the Bay Area, when I was doing it at the time, my skits with Louis Better Sonny Bo, I was like, I'm not going to say like. I have to just tell the truth. I was the only person that's doing skits
Real shit.
I was more like on some like, damn, it's a nigga in L.A. that's doing the same shit I'm doing. And this nigga, it's not like I knew who you was, knew who I was. It was just more like, but this nigga's doing all the hood L.A. skits, and I'm doing all the hood Bay skits. Well, I gotta tap in with this nigga.
Yep.
So I'm like,
merge the cities together, because the Bay and L.A. is cousins.
Exactly.
I tell this nigga, oh shit, I'm
sorry. Oh, you didn't drop the weed. Talking about nigga.
This four Bay nigga just put their head down. Bruh. This nigga here, bro.
Oh, you done dropped it. Oh, you shit. Good? You got to know. Oh, you got. Oh, you already got a blunt.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so you A1. You all right. Bro, you got to have a blunt.
But hell yeah, man.
I'm dropping Ryan weed. Fuck Ryan. That's how I feel right now. Fuck Ryan.
See, that's why L.A. in the best country. That's some shit.
Nigga, fuck this nigga.
Why you getting some weed?
So
yeah, nigga, but it's a blunt for him. Because he don't know how to twist wood.
Bro, that's hella funny. But no, like, yeah, you was the first person that, I feel like just California-wise, because I was, like, in the bay on the island doing all these skits just to the neck. That's why I had the Sonny Bow and the Nerve Brush, because I didn't have no other person with a comedian mindset, like a, you know, comedy, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Little it factor in the equation where I could collab with somebody. So for when I seen you, I'm like, oh, this is a reason to go to L.A. You feel me? Like, I'm on to L.A., nigga. Yeah. I'm going to tap in. So when you respond, I'm like, oh, yeah, for sure. We going to work. So when I pulled up on you, I just peeped, like, on some bay shit, I thought y'all niggas had it made. I'm just like, these niggas going crazy because they in L.A. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's why I judged Teddy and you. I'm like, only reason these niggas going crazy out there because they in L.A.
So that's going to make your journey harder.
Real shit. You know what I'm saying? So when I came down and I see you was at, you know, your parents' house and all this shit, your mom's and shit, and I'm like, you really, like, you a nigga. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, you had your little brother recording you at the time. Yeah. I'm thinking you had a whole production team, all type of shit, because you were in L.A. This nigga was in the hood with his little brother recording him. So I'm like, oh, so this how we fucking with it?
Yep.
My nigga, this how I fuck with it.
That's why, that's why, nigga, love you to death for that, my nigga, because
you back, family, your mama.
It meant a lot, bro, because, you know, in the city, it's hard to collab with niggas that's cool. Yeah. The city is very, like, jealous and to themselves. So, to meet a nigga from the Bay that just had love and fucked with me, like, nigga, you leveled up my game, bro. You let me know that I can continue to be funny, my nigga, and be able to work with people well. Because I tried, but niggas acted funny. So, I felt like maybe it was me. Mm-hmm. But just working with you and how niggas' energies, like, matched. I didn't try to be this. You didn't try to be that. It just, I'm saying, came together, my nigga. And, like,
and y'all walking in your own identities. You feel me? Like, I feel like it's not hard when you yourself.
Exactly.
To be yourself around other people. It's only when you a leader and it's and what's the word? Insecure about your position in life that you feel like you gotta do certain shit to, no, nigga, be you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
yeah.
Shine bright.
Yeah, and that's what I felt pulling up on Quan. I'm like, nah, this nigga's like a real person. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I was more like, shit, I'm coming back and fucking with this nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm glad that nigga did, though, on God.
Yeah, that shit was. So what made you come up with those, like, because it would have been hard for me to do what I was doing at that time with just without Sonny Bo. Sonny Bo was like my little outlet to just be like, to compare shit, you know, because like the Bay Area, like gang banging to LA is like a dreadhead nigga. Like, you know, the gang banger, the blood or crip, whatever, it's like our dreadhead nigga. So it's hella, we don't got gangs, we just got hella niggas that's tripping with dreads. You feel me? So it's like, that was my way to talk about every hood scenario. You feel me? Without, I can do all my hood scenarios with one person, me and Sonny Bo. So what made you come up with saying, like, first of all, just to do a skit off the dribble during a time where that wasn't popular, and what made you take, like, I'm going to talk about all the politics in L.A., because that's a dangerous route to go, knowing what I know now about L.A.
And that's a good question, because that's one of my questions, because I'm from L.A., and there's a lot of shit that you do that I would never. Just because I know what come with it, you know what I'm saying? But it's, you give your answer.
Just to keep it a buck, bro, it was just, I was trying to make myself laugh, like, during, like, a hard time in my life. Like, man, like, my pops was killed, like, in 2011.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so I was trying to, like, really just figure out something to do and just make myself laugh. So I did my first video, nigga, how gang members danced at a party, and it was me Hoover stumping, and the shit went viral.
That's the one you did to the sugar free.
Yeah, you
are. Like,
bro.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Every nigga like this, nigga, it's some moving gangsters in that motherfucker. I'm like, oh yeah. Y'all better run anything hood, nigga. Y'all. Man. But yeah.
Still, you'd be like, okay, I'm out of here.
Yeah, God, I'm out of here, nigga. So, but it was just basically that, and I was like, I want to follow up, but I wanted to tell the authentic LA story. I didn't want to give it like the movie story. The movie story is cool, but it ain't really how it is. Like, it's more into it.
I say this, like Ice Cube was saying about Friday, niggas have more fun in the hood than that. Like,
yeah, exactly.
Y'all be making the hood like hella stressful.
You
gonna
die as soon as you get off the freeway.
Yeah.
It's not
that. Niggas wake up with just you know what I'm saying? A good heart.
So
it's when you go outside and see
Now you gotta tighten up.
Like, all right, nigga, I'm cool, nigga. I ain't even gonna slide there, but it was just, I wanted the world to see it from my eyes and my point of view, and just like let them know like what my thoughts of LA, and also just be a motherfucking learner's guide to anybody trying to maneuver through the fucking city.
Yeah. So you want, you basically like on some, so with you making that first video, who filmed that video? Your little brother?
That first video, my little brother filmed it.
So you was like on some like, you knew it was gonna work, or you like, you just trying to make yourself laugh, and you like, fuck it, I'm gonna just do this, and this is how I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, I didn't know it was gonna work. I just did it to make myself laugh. Nigga, I was bored. Nigga, I was fresh out of high school. Nigga, I was like, nigga, I need something to do.
Yeah.
You feel me? So like, I just started making videos.
Yeah. I was like, I'm either gonna do this bullshit outside with my niggas every day, or I'm gonna do something like better. Like,
yeah. You gotta pick something, my nigga, because like, pick something.
So I see how it was building up to that because so that was your first one because that's a legendary skit.
Yeah,
that's
that
a legendary one.
Yeah.
So it's like your first one, boom, you like, oh, this is what people fuck with?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do hell of these.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it came, or you was kind, more like...
Kind of in a way because I was trying to figure out a way to be real but not tell too much, you know what I'm saying? But figure out a way to craft it in a way that I can tell people about the city but like also like... Not be like one of them, you know, one of them motherfuckers.
Not to be the police.
Yeah, like a colonizer nigga. Like, come over, take over, and just say, hey, look, this how you. Nah, I just want to tell the story from a real point. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And I feel that, because when I watch it, I don't see no disrespect.
Come on.
But when I'll see Hollywood people try to do certain things, and it be like, that's a hella disrespectful.
Yeah, niggas. Like, come on, my
niggas
nigga.
Really have died for this.
Like, real shit.
Yeah.
So
you gotta always take. I've turned down hella shit just because they be like, nah, I'll do certain shit, but y'all won't be the clown too much.
Yeah, like nigga, I'm not finna coon for nobody, nigga. Yeah. I'm not finna do that. But
yeah
that's basically.
Yeah, that, yeah, you was.
I didn't know it was gonna
people.
Go. Yeah, I'm got no. I ain't one of the first.
Yeah, like you are
first,
the first,
nigga. First, nigga.
That's a fact.
To keep it a buck.
That's a fact.
The first to do it.
Yeah.
It was dangerous. It still is dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
My biggest thing was just keeping God first, but also just moving around with respect, going to these different areas, and I'm reaching out to the real people that's from these areas, not just to get an actor, nigga. It's like, hey, bro, I want to try to get you in the skit. And the thing about it is, bro, every hood nigga that I do a skit with, and you know what I'm saying, whether they was like really in the streets, left the life alone, but still there, you know what I'm saying, I showed them niggas that they can be an actor, bro. I swear to God, like, a lot of niggas told me, like, bro, I want to be an actor. Could you put me in some more shit? Can I do this? Can I do that? Like, I had niggas really tell me that, fool, and that shit meant a lot because I wanted to, like, help somebody around me. I didn't want the skit to just be about me. So a lot of the times, I'm not even the turned up nigga. I'm the regular LA nigga. Let them take the shine because
let y'all show the truth.
You know what I'm saying?
I'll just reflect it.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and y'all just like, you got a kid, bro. You need something. If I can help with just one thing for somebody to see you and put you on something, I'm fulfilling my purpose, bro. I don't want shit. I just want to, like, be able to get you one opportunity, my nigga, because I see you got potential. Like, the hard thing about the hood is, like, your homies, a lot of times when you in the street, niggas ain't going to try to tell you your dreams is cool. So, niggas not going to want to do it. It's a nigga that I fuck with named Picasso. He in jail right now. He from NHP. He did a skit with me, bro. He wanted to become an actor, nigga. Yeah. He kept hitting me up to do skits, but I was busy, you know, writing skits and doing skits with different areas and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like I didn't help him enough, and bro went end up going back to jail.
Yeah.
And I'm like, fuck, if I could have like been a little free to help this nigga.
I know exactly how you feel, so, Quan, because I feel like that's why I think that's something that you put in the universe with your actions, and I feel like that's what made me gravitate towards your movement too.
Appreciate it.
Because you, all you saying is you got in this shit, you know, you found a lane for yourself and you want to inspire others and open up another lane and say, hey, you can do this shit too.
Right. Exactly.
I done literally seen you put gang members in a skit. Real nigga, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's like, I can relate to that because I'm in a whole Bay Area where I'm the only nigga comedian.
Yeah.
So I'm not linking with comedians. Nigga, I'm telling, hey, my nigga, I'm nigga, everybody really Sonny Bo. Yeah. So I'm like, hey, my nigga, be Sonny Bo with nigga real fast. And we gonna walk up to the... So niggas, good niggas really happy. Like, ooh, nigga, this shit wrong.
Oh, man.
Or they felt like they done something
real
that day.
Shit.
For fucking doing a skit with me or something like that. So it was very inspiring. And I know exactly what you're saying because most of the people... the hood got the funniest niggas.
On God, on
like,
God.
The real hood niggas are the funniest people. I'm not
trying to. Nigga, on God, like, bro.
I'm not funny, nigga. Y'all niggas.
Like, nigga, every nigga from LA, Compton, Long Beach, Inglewood, whatever, got a fucking uncle that will shoot on you till you want to fight that nigga. Like, shut up, my nigga. Stop talking about me.
Man.
Niggas is fucking hilarious. Yeah. That's where we get the game from. So. Either grandma, auntie, uncle. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? Smokers in your family is funny as fuck and inspire some comedy shit too. Cause I got an auntie, that bitch a thief, nigga. Like, she was hugging on my mama one time.
You can't even hug her.
Hey,
bitch.
Hey, nigga.
This nigga said she was hugging on my mama one time.
But she hugged on my mama, my nigga was like, hey, Lane, you got some nice earrings. Rub her ear, right?
Oh.
Took my mama earrings out her ear, bro. Shit. While she was talking, my mama didn't feel shit. Her son told my mama, he said, auntie, you notice something different? She said, different, what the fuck you talking about? Nothing different. He was like, look at your fucking ears, man. My mama got your earrings. Damn. So my mama went to the kitchen. The bitches in the kitchen like, yeah. So who make the potato salad? And my mama said, bitch, get my earrings back. I said, that's a cold motherfucking thief, nigga. Like, that's some comedy shit.
That's a movie scene.
Like, nigga,
they did that hella quick, too.
And they really living it. It's not a joke.
You know what I'm saying? Like, a bitch, my mama had bamboozle, so how you fucking flick the latch to, like, you know what I'm saying, get him out her ear? But the bitch had both of them. Sorry, auntie, I may call you bitch, but you did bitch shit.
Wow.
And that's what you is right now.
That shit crazy. No, the most serious motherfuckers, man, rest in peace, my nigga Busco, man. He was out of Berkeley, man, one of the funniest. He was the person that made up one of those.
Oh, damn, he that's was crazy.
Real nigga, though. Real, just a authentic, funny nigga.
Damn, that's crazy.
Did that shit just being like just himself, and that shit blew up and shit and did out. I was back and forth to the Bay in LA at the time, dealing with Hollywood motherfuckers. I'm really in a meeting arguing for Busco, like, bruh, my nigga made this shit up. Like, he started one of those. Like, these motherfuckers got rich. Whoever did the business part behind it, they really got rich off of this nigga movement.
That's fucked up.
So, like, when I was going back to the Bay, I done a few skits with him. I was telling him, I took him to a comedy show. Bruh, I swear to God, bruh, this nigga performed for the first time. I took this nigga. I said, bruh, you could be a comedian, bruh. Took the nigga to perform at an open mic. Bro, I'm telling you, naturally funny. I never see nobody go up for their first time and do that good.
That's
crazy. Like, bro, you're better than me. I'm really begging this nigga, bro, be a comedian.
Yeah.
But he was just so, you know, involved with the streets and shit. He was more about the money. Because it's hard to convince a motherfucker to get in comedy if you're about the money. If you like a nigga about some money, you like, I ain't got time for no
money. It's a long road till you get to some money.
Real shit.
Like, you got to really be like, nah, nigga, this is meant for you.
Real shit.
Can't nobody else do this but you.
On God.
This is your purpose. Purpose is bigger than money, because purpose is going to open up the doors to hella money. Nigga, you worried about some little buddy, nigga, get post office, what was the saying? Post office always hiring, nigga.
Yeah.
Mama's son.
That's some real ass shit, bro. That needs to be like on a motherfucking t-shirt. Like, that was like the realest bar, my nigga.
I mean, it's
that's
just,
the realest bar.
You better
bar.
Print it up. They're gonna watch this episode next week. We're gonna have some nigga out there selling some shit Teddy said.
Niggas right there outside of the Inglewood Forum, nigga, with the shirts and shit, like, listen to what we said there. It's always hiring. Nah, but man, my nigga, like, you are a real person for that, bro. Like, God got you walking in your purpose, my nigga, for you to, like, want to help somebody, bro. Like, that's the biggest thing. Like, niggas don't see the behind-the-scenes work. They don't see Lou talking to niggas and, like, pushing niggas. They don't see all that shit, bro. So, like, just knowing that, I know he ain't on no bullshit. I know, like, this nigga, we know this nigga. So, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So, like, just to know, just hearing you saying that, and I know that's the truth, my nigga, you a real nigga for that, bro. Because you took me to my first comedy show, my nigga. When we went to go see DC Young Fly and SCP.
Yeah. We did go to that shit.
That was my first time, bro. And that, like, that moment, nigga, I was like, bro, I low-key want to do stand-up, bro.
Wow. How do you feel about that? Because I know it's, like, tough to, like, because you really in the lane of your own. Like, you really, like, on some, like, you really, like, I can't compare you to anybody because you one of one.
Appreciate
so
that.
So it's just like
Appreciate
you're on a lane of your own. Well, I don't fully even know that if you need to do stand-up or not. Because stand-up is really about, it's like a different art.
Yeah.
Like, that's how me and Teddy connection is like. Because Teddy is like a stand-up comedian, like, number one. He knows that shit to the T, where it's like, I be on my little doubts and searching. Teddy be like, nah, this how, it's like that. And I be like, okay. Like, you feel me? Like, if I wasn't about this shit, it's easy to just not do it.
Yeah.
You feel me? Because it's nerve-wracking. It's It's
you so want to quit.
You want to quit all the time.
All the time. Mm-hmm. It's so. It's so. It's like being with a bitch that don't respect you.
That's a good ass experience.
Man, this nigga is fucking naturally fucking funny.
But
bro.
The bitch love you, though.
The bitch love you, but she ain't.
Like, her respect for you sometimes. It's like,
she love you, but she don't respect you.
It be certain That's shit that wild. You gotta do to gain her respect that you... It's ego checking.
Yeah.
It's a lot of ego checking in this shit, my nigga. Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly what it is, Ted.
So I'm
looking at you like, if we comparing it like that, right? Yeah. You in a lane where you got your girl, she love y'all, understand each other, y'all. Mm-hmm. You don't want to go fucking with this bitch I fucked with. You know what I'm talking about?
I feel you.
Because I got in the skit game after I was a comedian, so I did this shit really on some ticket sales shit. Yeah. I'm just helping. I'm doing this shit so people can know me by face, so I can sell some tickets.
Yeah,
it's the only reason why I keep up the internet. Cause I got some shows,
and I need y'all to fuck with me.
I feel like you more like I'm starting to be like, nigga, are you like the real nigga version of like Terry Crews or something? You know how Terry Crews ain't think he a comedian?
Yeah.
But he's not a comedian.
Hey, bro.
Terry Crews is disgusting. I said real nigga version.
Don't disrespect, nigga.
I said real nigga version.
This nigga's not Terry Crews, nigga.
Terry Crews getting money. Y'all niggas tripping.
Hey, now pause, nigga. I was just.
Pause
it was
a on that. This nigga did touch my earlobe.
It was a demonstration. My fault, y'all.
You know what I'm saying? Marlon Wayans without the stand up comedy.
Yeah, but that's, I mean, like.
It took Marlon hella years. I'm feeling, not to say like that, I'll say you probably. Follow a route of like a Marlon, not to the T or nothing. You gonna do you the whole time, but as far as like it's just taking you a while to get to the stand up part.
Yeah,
you think you want to do it?
I mean, it's I don't want to like take it full on, but I want to try that shit. Honestly,
you know what? You should do it because it's a lot of motherfuckers that's doing stand up right now, and they don't even respect the game enough to even say like, should I do it or shouldn't?
Yeah,
you because you looking at it more like as the game, like should I? Because you know stand-up comedians. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's versus like, it's a lot of people that's popped off the internet and then they fucking get money. They selling out shows and all type of shit. And they not even telling no joke.
Yeah.
They just up there. That's who they are. You're so creative. You gonna come with some shit because you're who you are.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're not Tiny 2 Extra. That's a character. Mm-hmm. WattsHomieQuan is funny.
Yeah.
So all you gotta do is be WattsHomieQuan on stage.
But that's also a part that's stalling me from doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And I know y'all niggas really do this shit, so y'all could tell me. But my thing was like, I respect the great so much, I don't want to bullshit it.
That's how I feel.
I want to know what the fuck to talk about. I want to know. I know this shit not going to be perfect because you got to get out there, but it's like the way that motherfucking Richard Pryor would kill a fucking stand-up shit, nigga, like, just watching these niggas, I'm like, bro.
I say this, bro. It took the niggas 20-something years to get to the point where they filmed it and you saw the greatness.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't start filming the first.
I mean,
I think that's the reason. I don't want to say that's one of the off-putting things about this generation.
Yeah.
Because everybody want to film it, put it straight up, all of that. Mm-hmm. Like you said, you did stand up first. You was already cooking with your shit first. And then you was like, how do I get more people there? That's young nigga thinking, because everybody on their phone.
Mm-hmm.
Let me do a skit, nigga. But like, as far as like the art of stand up, it's just something you just gotta keep fine tuning, nigga, and perfecting, and really reaching deep within yourself.
Yeah,
to
you gotta look at it like it's a place to be.
Yeah,
somewhere to go. That
Cause I go through a lot of shit. I be wanting to talk to somebody, my nigga. So
on
that
stage, your mama, son.
Real shit, bro. Like I got motherfucking problems, my nigga. But
talk about them shit.
But just I just
check for it, nigga.
Yeah.
That's the craziest part, nigga.
Cause you gonna start off the dribble getting paid.
I'm getting the check. Because
you got a fan base.
Yeah.
You getting a check, nigga, for some shit you should be telling.
Nigga, I perform so much for free, nigga. I was damn near crying when I started getting some money off stand up.
Nigga, this is me. It's like a dumb
as fuck. Nigga, I been through hella shit.
Your first money?
Yeah, when I first started getting money, you know, on stage.
I remember my first $1,500 show, nigga. I was like, $1,500
for how many? Oh, God, nigga.
For just a couple minutes.
Nigga, when I did a show in Sac, nigga, I thought I was motherfucking Kevin Hart. I said, nigga, I did a show in Sac, nigga.
Yeah.
Like, nigga, Sacramento for me was like a place like I didn't grow up going to Sacramento. I didn't have no family out there, yeah. So it's like I didn't play hella sports at high school, being hella bad and shit. Yeah. So I never just went to Sacramento. So for me to go to Sacramento and people knew who I was, I was like, oh shit! Like you feel me? I want to damn near drop a tear, like nigga. Yeah.
So that shit, man. That shit.
That's another thing with stand up too. You get to feel your love,
right?
You feel me? Like you know, you got so much love in the Bay. You got so much love, and then you can't. You know, a comment is one thing, but when motherfucker walk up, you know, because you be outside of L.A. Nigga walk up, like, I'll fuck with you.
Yeah.
You in L.A., so you know, like, oh, yeah, for sure. But,
yeah,
you know, nigga, you go a different place. I was in Canada, and motherfucker was like, hi. I'm like, nigga, you what? You know me, man? Like, nigga, I'm the same nigga. Yeah. So I was like, that shit crazy.
Yeah, man, that shit will fucking, like, change you, bro.
Yeah.
That shit will fucking change you, nigga. Yeah. Like I got banged on by a nigga in Atlanta that knew me off Instagram, but he didn't like he was banging on me playing off of my skits, but I didn't know because I didn't know the nigga.
Yeah.
But the nigga's from Sixties, So he's like I'm trying to cut a night bud. I'm like, what's up, nigga? Like, cause I'm looking like nigga, you not in L.A. So would you?
Yeah, he really banging on me.
Nigga, like, nah, I'm just playing with you, cuz nigga, 6'0" crip. You funny as a motherfucker. Like,
yeah.
But like, in his mind, he joking. But
yeah, but I'm still like,
he probably respected the fact that you locked up.
Yeah. Like, hold on. Oh, mamas. Like, nigga did that to me in the club. Nigga touched me in the club. I'm in the club, nigga. I'm in the San Francisco, nigga, the city, nigga. So it's like, nigga touched me. He like, nigga, you do too much.
Yeah.
Like he said, you not a club hella loud. Yeah. He's street, nigga, you do too much. So I'm like, what the fuck you mean? I'm doing too much, nigga.
Yeah.
And he's like, nigga, you hella funny, nigga. I'm like, oh my nigga. I'm like, nigga,
we doing it.
Man, I'd be like, man, damn.
I mean, it's just like a nigga out here telling you, bro, look, what's your first opening? You'd be like, hey, check it out, bro.
Don't wave me over here.
Hey, check it out, my nigga.
LA niggas is
if
no
I don't see no like, kids over there.
Check it out, my nigga.
If I don't see no kids over there, nigga, I'm looking too wild, nigga. Like,
I mean, like,
the only nigga that really got that out of me was, nigga, my Hawkins.
Yeah.
Nigga, he was with his kids. He was like, all right, blood, you that nigga off YouTube?
Check it out.
All right, my kids fuck with you, blood. I don't know you.
Yeah, let
I
me
was
get
like, okay.
Yeah, like that's the funny part though. Like let him know, nigga. Niggas like that in LA be cool. Like they be like, nigga, I don't know you like that, but my people fuck with you, my nigga.
Man,
nigga
like, my kids.
I'm like, I respect your honesty, my nigga, but you aggressive.
Yeah.
So I gotta earn another fan?
Yeah.
I feel like
WattsHomieQuan
got the most dangerous fan base. All social media influencers. I didn't deal with this nigga, and we just go get some food, nigga. We be in the real LA, so nigga, we go soul food, all type of shit, and it just be nigga just 30 tear eye drops, nigga. Just hey, homie, on the set, you hella funny. You feel me?
Yeah.
God damn, nigga,
I love it. Like,
they want this nigga pull up to every set.
Yep.
So I be like, man,
nigga tried to book me to perform at they hood day.
Nigga, I'm like, what the fuck?
I don't perform at the hood days, man. You know what a hood day is? Basically the holiday for the hood.
It's for the hood.
Whatever day your number, your block line up on the like.
Yeah.
Certain days you gotta be like, where are we at, nigga?
Yeah, I mean like, oh yeah, oh God, nigga. Any other day, I'm not going certain places, nigga. I'm like, oh that shit from the slots ain't gonna wait, nigga.
I get that next week.
I got educated fast for Quan, cause I used to pull up, do skits. I always pull up and then Quan, it was one day you told me like we can't shoot this day because it was the day where niggas getting killed for no reason on the day. It was
I think it was during 100 Day 100 Nights.
Oh, that shit.
It was either that or I think it was somebody hood there or some shit.
No, it was that shit. 100 Day 100 Nights. I'm like, nigga, that movie or something? I'm going to do a skit. This nigga like, yeah, we can't go over here. Nigga, what?
No, we can't. We can't.
And I believe you. I'm like, I respect hoods, nigga. So, I don't give a fuck what hood I'm in, nigga. I respect hoods. So if nigga tell me something about hoods, this how this shit run?
Because
I be quick. That's why I be happy when I tell niggas about areas and they don't listen to me and it happened. I'm like, see, I told you.
Exactly.
I told you, why? I'm glad you still here for me to tell you that you were wrong.
I told, I went out with Ryan and Teddy. We was in the town. And we wasn't even in town. We was in Antioch. I'm like, yeah, nigga, put your shit in the car because niggas be dipping cars, right?
Yeah.
Niggas, Teddy didn't say nothing. Teddy respect hoods. This nigga Ryan.
Yeah, he like, nigga, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, that's what he kept saying. We had Applebee's.
I don't give a fuck.
Niggas don't give a fuck about where you at certain places. Nigga bent the car. Nigga, he was sad. Nigga, I was happy. Like, I told you, nigga. Well, I be with Quan. I listen, nigga. You be like, nigga, don't wear black, red, blue, or green. I be like, I come in a line. Yeah, I wear lime green, nigga.
Niggas be looking hard like, ooh, that look kind of greenish.
You're like, all right, my nigga. You ain't a gardener, nigga. All right.
That's hella funny.
Politics of the city is wild. Like, and the fact I think the niggas respect me so much because they still see that I'm touching arms with them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'll never be on no weird Hollywood shit, bro. It was only one time a nigga didn't have time at the Fox 2's Mall. So if you watching, bro, nigga wasn't on no funny shit. I just had to go. Had my son with me.
It's always be like that.
But it's always, it's gonna be a couple of them.
Yeah, I love everybody, but sometimes you can't hug everybody.
Yeah, you feel me? But like, my nigga, like, they just fuck. They be like, bro, like, you a real nigga, bro. Like, nigga, I done been at shit where it was uncomfortable as a motherfucker, bro. I was at the fucking movie theaters, like, you don't know, you know what I'm saying? Peeing, all right, nigga, double take. Said, Quan, my nigga, what's up? I'm like, what's up, bro? Yeah. Like, what the fuck am I supposed to do, talk to you right now, fool?
Yeah.
But the nigga was like, hey, fool, after you get done, let's get a flick. I'm like, my nigga, can I wash my hands first, my nigga?
But like, to him, like, I just realized niggas was raised different. Everybody raised different, my nigga, because it's so many fans that I would have fired on. But I didn't want to be that nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want niggas to leave and be like, oh, that nigga tell you a bitch. You know? Somebody going to say it.
Somebody going to say it for sure.
Quan, I got a question.
Yeah.
How is you doing all this shit? Like, you chose to do this shit by yourself, or like with just you and your brother and your family and shit, or was no other option? Because it's 2021.
Yeah.
When you was doing it, 2014, 15?
I say, starting 14, yeah.
14, right? It was nobody doing it, so you wasn't influenced by anybody.
Yeah.
Did you had a choice to like collab on motherfuckers? Because I didn't collab with a lot of people till recently because it's more influencers now.
Yeah.
But back then, I didn't have no choice. Did you have a choice, or you chose not to, like, I'm not fucking with niggas. I'm going to just do this shit myself because I don't got to fuck with niggas.
Nah, I didn't have a choice.
That's crazy.
I came in this shit with my arms out to fuck with everybody. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, you from the city. Niggas is, like, real weird. Like, niggas don't love to help niggas. They feel like, okay, nigga, if you get more attention than me, I can't fuck with you. I can't put you on. Versus a nigga just been like, nigga, I fuck with you, nigga. Whatever happens, happens. Why? Because it's already destined. Your shit for you. Your shit for you.
Right.
So I had to do it myself. I went to a couple skid houses, nigga. You know about this shit because you a fucking comedian.
Skid house in North Hollywood.
All the skit niggas. The skit houses.
I never tapped into that.
I pulled up to like three of them bitches and it just was odd.
Weird because them niggas don't fuck with me because I'm telling them when they talk about hood shit, I'm like, nah, you can't talk about that. You can't do that. It would be like this. They don't like to be like
corrected.
To be correct. But I'm like, nigga, I'm from here, fool. Yeah. And then when they know where I'm from, or if a nigga like telling my name, they go look my shit or watch my shit, and then they feel like scared and something like, my nigga.
That's what
I'm
like,
gonna break into
you,
that shit.
Yeah, like, your shit was too authentic. One thing I learned about like the skit motherfuckers on the other side of the valley.
Yeah.
They don't like shit that's authentic. They think everything gotta look like a fucking joke.
Yeah.
And that's what made me like, we gotta do what these square niggas doing on the other side. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, that wasn't gonna work because you trying to like, you on some like, you know your shit.
Yeah.
So motherfucker can't tell you how to do your shit.
Yeah.
So I see what you're saying. Cause that's like a motherfucker telling me, this how bae niggas be. You're not gonna tell me how bae niggas be like.
Yeah.
Like, I'm gonna show you this.
Exactly.
Bae. You don't tell me nothing about the bae. So I can do every city. Richmond,
come
city,
on.
All the shit. Don't tell me about, no, the city guys wear ducktails and I already knew that, nigga. Don't tell me what city niggas do.
Come on.
So that's like, what,
how you can tell me about being me and I'm trying to tell you how to make your shit better? Not even on no, because I don't have a post like, nah. I'm like,
I'm not telling you. I'm like, hey, dead the whole shit. I'm like, nigga.
I'm like, change that because they don't do that. Like,
Because
out here with the gangbang shit, you gotta, it's certain conjugations you gotta change in words. If you a blood, you gotta pronounce certain shit, but they don't know that.
Yeah.
So they overdo it. So I'm like, you overdoing it.
They doing it too commercial.
But then they get mad at me for that shit. Mm-hmm. And then they tell me to do some shit like, hey, homie, we's happening over here. I'm not finna do that walking off from the city.
Pull up to the, like,
come on, my nigga. What
you
the fuck?
You gonna have to damn near line it up for pulling up like that.
Real
anyway,
shit.
Just on some
nigga, I'm telling you. when y'all listen to this fucking podcast, it's one thing you gonna remember about this podcast. Check it out, my nigga. So if I would have did that anywhere I go, hood niggas, hey, check it out, my nigga, because you make the city look funny.
Yeah,
I can't go out like that.
LA niggas need that from you. It don't be a question. It don't be like, may I please have your fade? Like niggas be like, I need that, bro.
Like nigga, I need that.
Like the extras.
If a nigga hit you with the weirdo, nigga, I need that. Yeah. Nigga, it's over with, nigga. Yeah. I don't want to deal with that shit.
Yeah, mamas, now you got to be mindful of all of that shit. Yeah. How you represent things, because people don't like to get represented the wrong way.
You feel me?
And that's why that was another thing. It's like, oh, I want to tap into the market, but nigga, I'm not. I'm all about being original.
Yeah,
and you are too. That's why I feel like our collabs be so dope.
Thank
because
you.
It's like, me personally, I look at like, I can't do the LA shit without Quan. It just don't feel right in my soul. You feel me? I'm not gonna try to act like gangbangers be like, oh, cause that's working for Quan. Yeah. It's like, nah, nigga, tap in with Quan. If not, leave it alone.
Come on, right,
get the, and tap in with the source, nigga.
Yeah. Exactly.
And don't that's just try to steal the sauce.
Yeah, and then I tell other niggas that do it too. Mm-hmm. I don't want to be the only nigga to do it.
Mm-hmm.
I try to reach out to certain people that do the shit from the city. A lot of them either act a certain way or act weird. So then it's like, out of my hands, bro. Okay, I still wish you the best, bro. Mm-hmm. I'm going to just stay back. But my thing is, when you doing this shit, be authentic, be original. Mm-hmm. Yes, certain things are, you know what I'm saying, done over and over again. Mm-hmm. But it's a certain way. You just don't take a nigga whole shit down to a T to where a nigga like, I know this is my shit. You taking the whole. Because at the end of the day, that shit is gonna run out because why? You don't have topics to do. You waiting on another nigga. You feel me?
Yeah, you pulling from something.
And then niggas know if you really from the land or not, or you just a nigga talking about shit. Niggas know that I'm really from the land. I'm in every hood, my nigga. I done a skit with them.
That's one thing that
your backdrops be killing me. I'm like, what is this?
That's one thing I noticed about Quan. A part of your recipe is that you have to be outside.
Yeah.
You can't do your shit without actually pulling up to the places. That's something that's another thing that I respect about your grind and I value because that's how I am.
Yeah.
I'm not going to talk about everything from the motherfucking house.
Yeah, I can't.
I'm finna go to where it is so you can feel.
Exactly.
That's why I don't got hella Richmond skits.
Yeah.
Nigga, I'm not pulling up to Richmond. I do the town. Nigga, I can do the city for tap in and Vallejo.
Yeah.
Nigga, I'm tapped in the rich, but the Richmond shit is that's different.
It's out
niggas,
of your hands,
outside of my hands, my nigga.
I don't want it to be out of your hands.
I'm out of them politics. Nigga. Y'all niggas taking this shit too far. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Niggas in Richmond be killing their own cousins and shit. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I can't get the Richmond down to the city. Nigga, the Bay.
Yep.
I'm not finna do every city, nigga. I'm finna just say the Bay.
Real shit.
You'll be going to all the other parts of the city and be like, rolling 60 niggas be like, motherfucking the jungles be. I'll be like, this nigga's a superhero. This nigga's going to the actual, all these hoods and doing the skits. And then it's like, you making it funny, so it ain't like you going over there and making like they hood is a joke.
Because
that's one thing you got to know too. When you start trying to reach the people, you can't make it like, nigga, I make everybody hood the most dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me, nigga? If I'm in the city, I ain't going, nigga, town business thingy, but you know I'm in this, not, it's town business, but nigga, we in the city right now. These niggas, I'm out here modeling my city, niggas. You know what I'm saying?
You gotta give it up for where you at.
Formula to the shit. And you have a formula. Yeah. And I see a lot of people try to copy you, but the part where they can't fulfill is the outside part.
Yeah, the outside part.
And the spirit don't connect.
Come on, exactly.
The spirit ain't. This nigga's spirit is good enough to go to all these niggas without no confrontation. No, like,
hey. Yeah. Check it out. Yeah, check it out.
But see, that's crazy, too, because at the end of the day, like me, like Lewis Belt is Sonny Boy, right?
Yeah.
But Sonny Boy is my getaway card to just be the fucking like 100% who I am. Like 100, nigga, no filter. So it's like, I could get in that bag and I'd be like, okay, I could just be Sonny Boy real fast.
Yeah.
And everybody loves Sonny Boy, right? Yeah. But like with you, you like a character, but you're not a character. Like WattsHomieQuan is a brand. It's like a character. Like motherfuckers ain't, when people copy you, they're not saying, oh, he acting like WattsHomieQuan. They're not saying like, they're saying they acting like WattsHomieQuan.
Mm-hmm.
And that's you.
Yeah.
So like, that's, how is it being like, Like, that shit is dangerous. Like, motherfuckers. Yeah. Nah. Like, I couldn't imagine if I was Sonic, bro.
Nah, yeah, man.
See what I'm saying?
It's just... It do be crazy because when I do be going to these places, not like that, but I don't know who be getting to it with who.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love everybody,
but, like, niggas, they give me respect because I come with respect.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not trying to do nothing to incriminate nobody, make they look crazy. It's just telling these stories... That
an authentic place.
Yeah. So they fuck with it. And I feel like, honestly, bro, I couldn't do this shit without God, bro. It's all God. Like, I thank him. I pray.
Yeah.
And I'm like, God, come to you humble as I know how. Ask you allow me to make it to this place safely and back safely. And God, make sure I'm good. And, like, the people that be from there that I do the skits with, like, them niggas, like, always tell me, like, bro, like, I respect you for wanting to fuck with niggas. Everything's, like, on a humble... cool experience. It was only one time. It was some weird shit, but like other than that, everybody fuck with me because of what rappers do.
You bridging the gap. It's kind of like when Don Kennedy, Nipsey, and YG collab with each other because it's like, my nigga, let's put the game banging shit aside, but let's represent it. Let's talk about the culture, but let's bring the city together. Mm-hmm. And it's like you're one person, and you done brought the whole city, LA County, together as one person.
Uh-huh.
See what I'm saying? I had Sonny Bo. Me and Sonny Bo done brought the whole band together.
Well, shit, y'all two together, that's why collabing is important.
I'm honored to be a part of some legendary skits in LA.
LA meets the Bay, nigga. Once we all do our movie, bro.
On me.
Off the
It's journey. A wrap.
Yeah, real shit. It's over. Real
and
shit.
It's coming soon.
That's all niggas. That's all niggas got in LA. The Bay, nigga. I feel like, nigga, not even that weak ass character, cause that nigga was weak. But nigga, like, nigga, Tupac and Poetic Justice, nigga. We like the L.A. niggas going to the Bay, nigga, for the weekend. Like, it's so much game out there. Like, it's like a second home to niggas that ain't even been to the Bay, just because the vibe and the feeling, my nigga.
I be telling this nigga, would you be honest to say the L.A. party be rocking, right? It be rocking.
Mm-hmm.
For some reason, do it not slap. Two times as hard when they start playing Bay shit.
Oh, God, nigga. Really?
He don't believe me, bro. I was like, nigga, the party we be going.
Oh, God, nigga.
We can't freak it. All that shit was going, nigga.
Nigga, half of the jerking movement, all that shit was y'all shit, nigga. Uh-huh. Like, bro, I could be like, are you here? Burn rubber on you quick as hell.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Niggas are hoover stopping that motherfucker like, baby.
Wow.
Like, the Bay shit, go, like, bro, all that shit, nigga. Whoop, pack, make it booty bounce. Let it go. We trying to run a train. Like, bitch. Like, nigga, the Bay. What kind of train?
A mommy train.
We trying to run a train. Oh, yo, man.
Big B.
Lots of bang.
Hey, girl, you freak.
Got pipe.
Give it a weekend.
Telling you, nigga. Niggas fuck with the Bay, bro. Nigga, I'm
part of the party, bro. I'm gonna make another plate. That's why I didn't know how to learn.
Bro, nigga. nigga, I'm telling you, my nigga. But like,
we're gonna run a train. I'd have been like, no, I don't do that.
niggas fuck with the Bay, nigga. I'm telling you, nigga. In LA party, nigga. I'm on this motherfucker like.
Wow.
Hitting the whole shit, my nigga.
Bro, if we had the internet back then, nigga, I'd be coming to LA with doing functions, nigga. We would have drove, nigga.
Nigga.
We would have been did this collab shit.
Hey,
our function, nigga. We'd have been famous for functions.
Nigga. What was that party? What was the name of them party that nigga was throwing in the Bay that was going crazy?
Project
nigga.
X parties?
Every nigga from LA wanted to at least attend one of them motherfuckers.
It was
bro.
A lot. We had the tune in the booty little functions.
Bro. But them shits was crazy.
Yeah, it was a lot of people don't even know that Project X parties. That was Guap Dad. Guap Dad 4000 and his partners. They
used to
throw little parties and shit. He used to be
that's
popping
crazy.
Shit. So,
that's
so it's crazy that that's Guap Dad 4000. I can
now,
say like who party it was.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Him and his clique. Those called the YBs.
Yeah.
Shout out to Guap Dad, man. Yeah,
I mean, nigga,
this whole squad, Bay Area Fools. I see y'all doing y'all thing, baby.
And I really feel like, nigga, Bay, like, influenced L.A. niggas. Like, L.A. niggas rap like Bay niggas. Rap on Bay beats, all type of shit, nigga. The reason why I wanted to grill was because of a Bay nigga. Like, bro, like.
That's crazy. And I feel like the rappers kind of don't speak on that because it's like, you know, the pride and ego.
Well, fuck, nigga. The West Coast is the West Coast. But, nigga, like, it's two sounds, nigga. It's that hood. Shit, and it's that Bay, nigga. That Bay is like, oh, this shit.
That's why YG had the Bay.
Like, the Bay
I didn't know where YG was from
what?
For a minute. When YG came out, boy, everybody loved YG.
And guess what YG was like partying to, probably growing up.
For that sure. YG was like the Bay Area LA nigga. That nigga was talking about all the shit Bay niggas was on. Fucking bitches and beat niggas up and shoot straps. He wasn't talking about the gangbanging shit like that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So we could relate. That's why it was tough for Nip to transition to the Bay. It took later, because when he started talking about his entrepreneurship and talking about being independent, that's when he got the Bay behind him. When he was talking about being independent. But Nip was so LA out, it was hard for... Everybody fucked with Nip on some, like, how you fuck for cash, but you not a hoe? Yeah. How I'm going to respect you if your pockets broke? We're like, who that nigga down there going crazy? Like,
whole lot of hoes.
Oh, mama, so we like,
clinic watch a bitch, you got to go.
You got to go. We like,
broke your pussy, you stank, you bar pole, lost the little ass that you had playing with your nose.
So this is what I'm going to say about the LA nigga.
Dedicate this to my last hoe.
So I got to start acting like an asshole. Oh, mama, nigga.
With the...
I'll be buying pounds. Oh, no, we can't.
Oh, my God. Nigga, how about you? Want to fuck the team, huh? It's money of a bitch's pussy. Never fuck
the team.
This nigga,
real LA nigga. He like, don't sing the whole Nip version.
Yeah, but.
No, boy, it ain't nigga. You see, Hey, man, this one, this is another thing I got to shout you out to. Shout out my nigga, WattsHomieQuan. For locking a nigga in. We did a legendary skit at the Marathon store, man, before my nigga Nip passed away. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
That was a legendary moment. Mm-hmm. I knew it was big. I knew we was doing something big, but looking back at it now, man, that's like, that's something that can never be done again, ever.
Exactly.
You know
what
I'm saying? So it's like, you feel me? That's just like a big shout out to you, because it was just so raw how you went about it, how you approached the situation. He went about it the right way. He tapped in. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my nigga Newport, man. Newport, I've been locked in Newport. You know, nigga, once you lock me in, we going to stay locked in. Nigga. So, so it's like we did the skit and everything, and it was dope. How, everybody tripping off. If you ain't seen the skit, check it out. It's all over. Just put in Lewis Belt, WattsHomieQuan skits. You going to find it.
You going to see it on YouTube.
You did Nipsey voice.
Yeah.
And it's like... everybody tripped out because they was like, bro, was that really Nipsey? But it was like, no, that was Quan. But Nipsey was tapped in because he gave us the okie doke to me. He confirmed that we can do it. And as soon as we uploaded, he put the comment on the shit.
Yep.
So that's why, like Quan went about it the right way. He tapped us in. Yeah. They called Nip. Nip confirmed they could do it at the store. So we pulled it. We did it.
Yeah.
Niggas was really outside. It was really 6-0.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I was on some, what's up with it, Lou? I didn't come to the store like, hey, what's up with it? I'm like, what's up, my nigga? My name Lou. You feel me? I respect what y'all got going on over here.
Yeah, ultimate respect.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah. Everybody the big homie. That
this nigga had real niggas in the shit. These no actors. I'm like, why orchestrating this shit? Okay, so this is what we doing.
Yeah.
He got hood niggas like this. All right, so this is what we doing.
Okay, nigga.
What's they see the perfect stand?
Oh, man, oh, God, nigga. Look,
where should I stand?
Yeah.
All right,
you the nigga I'm not fucking with in this video. Yeah, you ain't fucking with me on the video.
Okay.
No, is that cool, Kerr? No, I can do it again, man. Like, niggas be like really wanting to perfect they shit all off of cell phone. We do this shit all off cell phone. Nigga, niggas put that much energy into like doing it right. Like, nigga, that's how niggas believe in your shit, because y'all got a fucking cell phone. Niggas could give you a half ass performance, but these niggas really want to do
it. They really could, but it was really out of respect of what you was doing.
And it ain't just a cell phone to them.
Yeah, nigga, that's a movie to them. Niggas, it's real.
Because you hear makes it a movie.
Yeah, bro, I swear.
I appreciate that. I don't ever like be thinking like that, but like that shit.
Bro, niggas be happy when you pull up to the hood. Bro, watch this nigga pull the phone out.
You really matter to the culture.
Thank you.
Like, you really matter. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, just to witness that and be a part of that was just legendary, and just to see your growth, you know what I'm saying? I know we're going to wrap it up soon.
Yeah.
But I just want to, you know, just get your roses while you can smell them, man. You know what I'm talking about? Just you know, you really matter, and I'm just proud of you. And you know, I seen you do the everybody was roasting you and talk bad about you when you was trying to get on Wildin' Out.
Yeah.
And, you know, because how you went about it, you really went out. The city of Los Angeles, L.A. County, got you on TV.
Yep.
You feel me? It wasn't no Hollywood shit, none of that. Mm-hmm. I felt like you deserved to be on the show. And you put your pride aside to make one of your dreams come true.
Yeah.
You feel me? And it's like, I feel like I live through you with certain shit, because Wildin' Out never been my passion.
Yeah.
But it's like, I like that. sucked it like I was on some. I just want to be on MTV. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't give a fuck about what show it is. You know what I'm saying? So that's why Ari the One. Really, I'm really thankful for that show and MTV as a network.
My first prayer was, I just want to replace Terrence J.
No, I don't want to be that corny.
Said he about to retire.
He was like,
all his clothes. No, I want to fuck with the bitches. You know what I'm talking about? That's what I was doing. I did my dream. You know what I'm saying? But to see Quan on there, it was crazy that we. You got on the show, like, we both got on MTV around the same time.
Oh, God.
You know, it was just crazy. But to see you be on that show, I just know how big that is because it's just, like, it give L.A. County just some type of real inspiration. Like motherfuckers didn't really see you from, like, I've been there. Like, shout out to your female, your woman, you know what I'm saying?
I appreciate
it. She plays a big part of your career. You got a rock solid woman, you know what I'm saying? And
somebody that's resourceful.
Young
lady need to teach a class.
His girl.
A master class.
His girl. So all the ladies talking about they want a nigga to do this and do that. Support a nigga to do it.
Come on.
I'm talking about be there for a nigga. Stop asking for some motherfucking money. Of course,
you can get a Birkin if you've been working.
I'm talking about You know, so just to see that, how you got your girl involved with your brand and everything. But I just seen you when Lil Brother was
recording.
So I just seen your whole, your growth, your level up, man. And you inspired me during this pandemic, man. It was in the pandemic, I wasn't inspired to do no skits because all my shows were shut down. Mm-hmm. So it's like, man, I never was like on some, let me do skits just to do a skit.
Yeah.
So it's like when the pandemic happened, it's like, I ain't got no reason to do a skit. Mm-hmm. And I see you ran it up during the pandemic. You was beating their ass with all the skits. I'm like, man, let me get up. Like, this nigga, you didn't make no excuse. You didn't make no excuse. It was a pandemic. You still created content. And shit, I believe what your YouTube channel would have shot up to, year.
Yeah, I got like, I think 169K subscribers.
And how many do you have before the pandemic?
I only had 300.
300?
300.
300 total.
Subscribers?
Yeah, 300.
Before the pandemic?
Before the pandemic. WattsHomieQuan ran it up on YouTube.
Honestly,
I want to salute you on that.
Appreciate it. I just want to tell everybody that's watching this shit, I just got tired. I got tired of struggling. Like, I'm still struggling now, bro. I was just, like, asking God to make a change, fool. Like, and I just, like, just got up and started doing skits.
You talk to God like that, like, hey, fool, like.
My nigga Lil JJ, he can tell y'all, my nigga, that's how I am, because I was finna fight a nigga at Water Now. And then right after I was about to, my nigga, he caught me outside praying. My nigga, I was like, hey, God, man, my bad. This nigga pissed me off, God. Like, I'm trying, my nigga. So the homie, he clowned me every time about that. But yeah, like, I just talked to God how I am. But
you
like,
got to.
I was so tired, fool, like, and struggling, my nigga. We all know how
to go. We all go through it.
I was like, okay, I'm scared of this corona shit, but I'm like, all right, if I just go and start just doing shit, knocking it out. Because first, I started doing shit with the background on TikTok.
Yeah, I seen
during
that.
The pandemic at first. I said, fuck it, I'm going outside. Mm-hmm. Nigga, I think we done did over, like, motherfucking 230-something skits over the pandemic shit. And they were just going. I was just telling niggas, go to my YouTube. And that shit just went crazy. I was like, nigga, fuck that, nigga. I gotta work. I was just tired, bro. I was just tired of
We all need each other for, you know, inspiration sometimes. I be seeing Teddy do his shit. I see you do your shit, and it just make me be like, all right, let me get up. Let me go crazy. You gotta go crazy. So, you know, I just want to thank you for the inspiration. You know what I'm saying? And this is only the beginning. You know what I'm talking about? This, like, only reason we talking about this part right now, because it's going to be a whole nother part after this. You know what I'm talking about? So it's like, you know, documentary style podcast. You know what I'm saying? We're going to tell y'all the old shit, but we ain't going to tell y'all the new shit. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
But
we this only the beginning. Update of where we at right now.
An update, man. So, you know, I appreciate you for sliding through. You know what I'm talking about? You got anything you want to promote, shout out, tell people to support? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. So, basically, I just want to say, check out my nigga Lewis Belt shit on motherfucking YouTube, Instagram. Check out my nigga Teddy Ray shit, YouTube, Instagram, Patreon, whatever these niggas got.
Oh, mama.
Support they shit, man, and just...
thank you for that.
Yeah, just whoever out there doing some shit, man, just fucking stay your feet planted. Just pray. Go for your shit. just don't let nothing like cripple you, my nigga. Like just go hard for whatever the fuck you believe in, and it'll start to manifest soon once you just continue to keep a positive attitude. It's gonna be dark days like a motherfucker, but fight through them dark days, because at the end of every fucking tunnel, it's a light beaming on you. Don't miss that light just because.
I'll stop in that tunnel.
Come on. Keep don't.
And be original and follow your heart.
Exactly.
Don't do what them other niggas doing. Come on. Do what you should do.
Come on.
You know, do what you want to do.
Do what you want to do. Nah. Do what you need to do.
Exactly.
Do what you, because niggas can do what they want to do. You ain't supposed to be rapping. You ain't supposed to be doing stand-up. You ain't supposed to be doing skits, nigga. Fuck all of that. I love everybody.
It's real shit, though. Real shit, though. But like, that's like the realest shit ever, my nigga. And then just like... Just don't be a weird nigga, man. Yeah, just like, don't... Just don't be weird, bro. Like, just really, like.
That's a real LA nigga. Don't just be weird. All
right, like just, not, you know what I'm saying? Don't be weird. Just really figure out what the fuck you want to do. Don't try to chase the life after a rapper nigga or whatever you see, because you don't see what really happens behind them fucking mirrors and lights. Remember, Instagram and social media is a fucking illusion. That shit's not real.
It's not so real.
Stop following that shit, man. Like, cause you gonna fuck yourself up trying to be like this other motherfucker, because they shit ain't pretty either. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, so,
just go through your shit, my nigga, and stay down, bro.
Stay down. Nigga. Stay dangerous, nigga.